Trabert and Dick Sakis will come out for the final day with a one-rubber lead. But the challenge round's by no means over yet. A win for Trabert will clinch the cup. The stage is set for a thriller. As both players shake hands with referee Cliff Sproul, no one in the vast crowd guessed just what a thriller it would be. Trabert first onto the court, apparently anxious to get into it. Hoad, as ever, seems quite unperturbed by the vital nature of this moment. Take it easy, fellas. You won't be needed for hours yet. Hoad opens the game. And here's a beautiful toss from Trabert that shows he's right at his top. Hoad again. That's 15-all, the first game. Still with the cardigan on, Hoad's gradually warming up. A lovely play. The youngster's playing with extraordinary confidence. Removes his cardigan before the second game starts. Trabert, big serve, plenty of power. But it's Hoad's point. It's a game of power services, and neither player can break through. Serve, an unplayable one. Here's another unplayable serve, and Hoad's 2-1. The change ends again, and an ace from Trabert. A slower serve this time, American twist. Hoad is pinned to the baseline. Serving in the odd games goes to 7-6, then 8-7. It's begun to rain now, the court's getting slippery. Hoad's the first to throw. Eight all, Hoad serving. Trabert flips, but watch it closely. And that's 9-8. Hoad still with a one-game advantage. Every Trabert service gives Hoad a chance to break through, but not while Trabert serves like that. Trabert's winning his service really well. Rain threatens as Hoad opens the 19th game. Once again, it goes with service, and the scoreboard shows 10-9 in Hoad's favor. Hoad really has to struggle to hold his service for the 21st game. duels, he's right. We're coming in at deuce, Trabert, a fault. He seems unbeatable. Oh, serving. And that makes it 4-1. Trabert's obviously upset by the crazy conditions of his fight. Oh, prefers not to change. He's only worn them once before and is undecided despite the slippery court. Oh, won the advantage and we're coming in at set point. Trabert, since he put on his spikes, is playing a lot better. After a word or two with Captain Bill Talbot, he goes out for the third set far more confidently. Trabert opens this time. And what a change comes over the game. Hoad finding the slippery court hard to handle. Trabert spikes up kicks with mud, but Hoad still in his band shoes. The American quickly sets up a lead, but Hoad is fighting back. Even Hoad's service doesn't function smoothly. He allows Trabert to break through and set up a 4-1 lead. At this stage, Hoad puts on his spikes, but you can see that he's reluctant. He's not used to them, but with Trabert setting up such a lead, he has to do something. Trabert's really determined now. His service is perfect. An American twist, and Hoad can't handle it. Did we say Tony was determined? Just look at that guy. He looks mean enough to tackle a tiger. You can almost hear him say, "Give me that racket, pal, and let's get this over with." And Hoad is still bewildered by the wet condition. Even his service seems to have let him down. He's really a worried boy now. He serves set point against him. And Tony Trabert down 11-13 and 3-6 has run through to take the third set, 6-2. At the end of the third set, Trabert begins the fourth. Despite his spikes, Hoad's still slipping. He's not at all happy. The drizzle has made the court very hard to handle. Lew Hoad seems to be making a comeback. And another ace. They were leading 5-3, but it's his turn to worry now. But this set is sewn up. Tony has set points. And a lovely stop, Tony. It's two sets all in the fifth. It's decided. More power to Tony. That was a good time back into the game. It's now that Hoffman's advice really begins to tell. Hoad goes out at 5-all and is right back into the game.